And welcome to La Voz Hispana, your Spanish newspaper.
Reynaldo, dime las últimas noticias de la semana.
La gran noticia de la semana es la detención de Francisco Pascual, un mexicano coyote o traficante de personas, quien, luego de traer a una niña desde California con dirección a Boston, la violó en un motel de Milford. La policía lo detuvo luego de que la niña lograra fugársele al tipo este.
Yes, a voyage of terror. There was a family from El Salvador who hired a coyote to transport their teenage daughter from Mexico into the United States to Boston. Meanwhile, Francisco Pascual, who was a coyote, stopped in a motel in Milford, raped her. She managed to escape. The police found her, and right now he is in custody for $2 million. That reminds me of a story that I heard here in the public school system about a teacher, an elementary school teacher, who was teaching about coyotes and asked the students if anyone had ever seen a coyote. So a young Mexican girl raised her hand, and she said she had. So the teacher said, no, you haven't seen a coyote. And then when they asked her, let her explain, she explained that a coyote is basically a person who transports people illegally into the United States. That goes to show how where we are in 2008, you would think that we would have more bilingual teachers, more teachers that are culturally sensitive to the new immigration issue that we have here in the United States. So I'm hoping that the Board of Education decides that this is something that they definitely want to work in.
Y dice mi compañera de aquí de redacción, dice que necesitamos más maestros bilingües hispanos que sepan explicar a los nuevos inmigrantes lo que está pasando en alrededor, que coyote puede ser un animal, como puede ser un traficante, ¿cierto? Y también esta semana tenemos la noticia de la contestación que le dan al artículo editado el año pasado sobre el pastor Armando Hernández y su regreso a New Haven. Una lectora nuestra escribió una carta muy buena, de que tiene mucha, pero mucha jugo. ¿Cierto que sí?
Yes. Okay. Many of you know that we reported about the return of Reverend Armando Hernández in previous issues of La Voz Hispana. We just received from one of our readers a very interesting editorial that we will be publishing in this issue of La Voz Hispana.
Y tenemos también que pensar en las estadísticas que dan de la ciudad sobre los tiroteos. Son muchos. Hay que hacer algo. Señores del Departamento de Policía, señor alcalde, pónganse las pilas.
Yes, there has been a large increase in the shootings that are going on in New Haven, and many of our young are dying. So we're hoping that that's also an issue that the police department will be dealing with this year.
Bien, y les deseamos a todos un gran feliz año. Próspero, mucha salud, mucha plata también, y mucho amor.
Yes, and we'd like to wish everyone a healthy, happy, and prosperous New Year.
Nos vemos.